I bought 3 broken Sega Game Gears. One of them includes this cool blue one that comes with the case. We'll work on this blue one last. Let's check out one of these black ones and see what we got going on. This video is sponsored by BW100. More on them in a minute. And overall, this one, it's got some adhesive on the screen. This screen is pretty scratched up. And let's check battery compartment. Actually looks okay. Those ones might need to be cleaned, but really not too bad there. I do have the AC power adapter, so let's plug it in and see what's going on. And we have, oh, we've got a line on the screen up there. Just a horizontal line there. Let's put a game in and see what it does. See if anything changes. Oh yeah, we got more lines up on the screen there. I don't hear any sound coming out of it either. So let's get this taken apart, see if we can figure out what's going on. I've only fixed a couple Game Gears in my life, so this is sort of all new to me. Looks like we got a game bit up here and some Phillips screws down here. This looks like the larger game bit. And it is. All right, there we go. And then I'm using a Phillips number 1 for these screws down here. Okay, I think that's all the screws. Is this just gonna lift off for me? No, of course not. There's some cables attached still. It looks like we got, this must be the power board over here. And this is, no, yes. And this is some other board. Pull up on this side. Yeah, there we go, okay. Okay. And one more right here. There we go. Okay, so we'll probably need to take a look at this power board, just make sure it's working properly. It doesn't seem to have an issue with getting power, so that might be just fine. Now, what I do know about these is they have an issue with these old capacitors. So the first thing we're gonna do is inspect this area, and then we're just gonna go ahead and replace them, but it looks like maybe I see a leaking capacitor right here. Let me show you what I mean. So right here, we've got like kind of some gunk on the board. It's actually not coming up with that. Let me go with the trusty dental pick. There we go. Some sort of gunk on the board over here. It looks like this capacitor is probably leaking. And we've got some more over here. So I'm guessing this one, yeah, this might be as well. This one's actually got a little bit of gunk right on the top. This one down here doesn't look too bad. And these ones over here, this one looks like maybe it's causing a problem. Possibly that one as well. So we definitely have some work to do here. There's also what looks to be maybe a dead bug. I got this capacitor kit from Handheld Legends. It looks like it's from Retro 6. They also have a guide to help you do this if you're not sure how. But that's what I have. So let's look at these and make sure they have everything we need. So we've got 1UF, 10UF, 100UF, and then capacitors for the power board, which is good because we might need those as well. Now it is important to note that the reason I'm just replacing all these capacitors on here is because there's such a known problem on these Game Gears. There's no point in really doing any diagnostic work or anything like that when we have known bad and some leaking capacitors on the board. So that's why I'm just gonna get these replaced, and then once the replace, then we can see what works and what doesn't, and if we need to do any further work on this thing. I think I will take this board out of the rest of the shell. I don't think that's necessary in order to do this job, but with it in the shell, you know, I might slip or I might accidentally rest my soldering iron along the edge of the case or something, and I want to make sure this case stays in good condition. So I'm going to go ahead and just remove the board out of the shell. Okay, now, yep. There we go. Oh, the screen's even gonna come out too. This is good too, because we can clean off the inside here if it needs to be cleaned off. We can check the condition of these button pads, which actually are in pretty good condition. We'll probably do a quick cleaning on them, but they're really not bad. And then we got the speaker down here. So I don't see any immediate issues with the screen. I'm hoping this screen is good, but you just never know on these things. I wish this would just unplug or something, but the screen flex cable is soldered directly onto the board, which is kind of frustrating because that means it's got to sit right on that when we're doing this work. But what I'm going to do is actually put it up on some tape like this. That makes it so it's not resting directly on the screen glass or anything like that. Now, I think we're ready to get to the soldering.
I used to never buy electronics cleaner because it seemed like no matter which brand I bought, it never really did what it said it was gonna do. That's all changed now thanks to BW100. BW100 is safe for all electronics, it's non-flammable, and it evaporates super quickly. And even better, it's also safe for plastics. We all know a lot of electronics companies have a problem with their analog sticks. A lot of times gunk just gets built up in them, and that makes them drift. Unless those analog sticks are completely worn out, BW100 works great to get them working again. I've used it on PS5 DualSense controllers, Joy-Cons, PS4 controllers, and Xbox controllers. But it's also great for things like VR controllers and drone controllers. But I don't just use it for controllers, you can also use it for motherboards that have any sort of dust or dirt or even liquid damage corrosion. It's suitable for all electronics from cars all the way to game consoles and controllers. I highly recommend BW100 for all of your electronics cleaning needs. I'll put a link right in the description that'll take you right to it.
So right here, you can see what looks like some corrosion, I believe, from this capacitor. That corrosion definitely can be causing a problem. So what we need to do now is break this free from the adhesive on the bottom. And then there's one solder point here and one solder point right over here. But we have to figure out the best way to break this thing free first. I'm not sure what that is. Right offhand. Oh, there we go. I'm gonna put some flux in there and bring in my soldering iron and see if I can pull that off without affecting any of the traces. If we tear off a trace, it's not the end of the world, but definitely easier if we don't. So I am just using my metal dental pick to kind of get the flux down in there. Now let's see if we can desolder this thing. Okay, I think we got one leg. Gotta get to that back leg though, that's an issue. And that smells disgusting. I need to turn on my air filter. There we go. And now the first one, and probably the hardest one, is done. Now we can move on to these guys right down here. And I'll show a couple more of these, and then I'll skip the rest so it doesn't get too boring. So I'm just gonna take my pliers and just pry on them just a little bit, just enough to break that glue loose. I mean, that's the goal anyway. There we go. And there we go. Now we can add some flux down here. And you can see that I'm a little shaky today. That's because it's lunchtime and I haven't eaten in a few hours. So a lot of people see me soldering and think that I'm just really not shaky, really calm all the time, or really steady all the time, and that is just not true. So I'm gonna get the rest of these done off camera, then we'll be able to come back and see if there's any other work that needs to be done and get it back installed into the rest of the case and see if it works after this. So we've got this capacitor, this capacitor, this one over here, this one over here, this one down here, this one down here, this one over here, this one up here, and this one over here. We've got all those replaced. They all look great. Now we need to get this board back into the rest of the case and then hook it all up and see if it works. We got a bunch of dust on the screen, which I definitely don't want. So can get almost all of it with canned air. Actually, I can probably get it all when I get a new can. That can's getting kind of weak. Got a little bit down here, but I'll get a new can of that so we can finish that up. The rest of everything, as far as I can tell, looks pretty good. So let's get this thing back in and test it out. Oh, we better clean the inside of this though first, because there's no point in cleaning that screen off if we don't clean the inside of the screen protector here. I just used some canned air on that. So that I think is good to go. Okay, now we can put some screws in and get the back cover on and we should be ready to go. Now we might have to deal with this power board as well, but I want to see if what we've done so far has made any difference or if we need to deal with the power board itself. So let's put it back together like this and just see what happens. I'm not used to these connectors. They're kind of strange for what I'm used to seeing. But there we go. Now we can close it up and put the screws in and give it a try. And before we get too crazy here, we need to get this adhesive off of the screen protector here. Might just need to replace the screen protector at some point, but for now, this will make it at least usable. And now, game in, power cable. Okay, is it gonna turn on and what's the screen gonna look like? Let's find out. Okay, can we see the screen? Where's the, oh, look at this. Oh, zero sound, but we get a picture on the screen. You can see that about right there the best probably. Okay, so that actually looks pretty good. Zone one, act one. Okay, wow, I have never played this before. Whoa, I have no idea where I went. Okay, so this screen is working, but we gotta get this speaker working. I do have a new speaker, so let's plug a new speaker in and see if that'll work. Okay, old speaker right here. Take that out. And new speaker. There we go. Okay, game. Let's plug it in, turn it on, and see if it makes any noise. Come on. I think it's supposed to be making noise right there. Yep, just zero noise. Okay, so we got to figure out why there's absolutely no sound coming out of this now. I think what we need to do next is pull off this audio board. This is the volume wheel here, and these are the capacitors that often go bad in the audio system as well. So let's get this metal cover off, and then we can take a look at that board. And there we go. Ooh, we got something going on down here. Don't know if that is from the capacitors or not, but got what looks like some corrosion down there. All right, let's get this under the microscope, take a look at these capacitors and get them replaced. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 capacitors to replace. And I'm gonna basically use the same method that I used for the other capacitors. I'll put some flux on the joints and then I'll bring my hot iron in, melt the joint while I pull up on the capacitor, and then come over and melt the other side while I pull up. And these look like they're probably also glued down. And then we'll come in and install the new replacement capacitor. And all of these 5 capacitors are all soldered on. The rest of the chips seem to look fine to me. So let's get this put back in and see if that fixes our audio problem. Okay, there we go there. Okay, good. Let's see if this thing is gonna have sound now. I really hope it does. Game installed and power is in. Make sure the sound is all the way up. And oh, that sounds beautiful. That is awesome. And we now have sound on this Sega Game Gear. So this one is totally fixed. Let's move on to the next black one and see what it needs. Yeah, this is the one that's definitely gonna need these battery contacts replaced. I might be able to get away with cleaning them, so I might try that first. Let's get the rest of it apart though and have a look at the motherboard. Oh man, look at this. Look at all that corrosion, holy cow. Oh, we got all sorts of corrosion all down here. We even have a capacitor that's like popped off the board. What happened there? That is weird. It looks, I don't know if it probably just corroded off. So this is the VA4 version of board. Okay, so I think what I wanna do here is remove this entire board so we can just really give this a good cleaning, and then it looks like we'll probably have to replace these capacitors as well. I'm gonna pull this connector off here. I'm gonna use my pliers and just pull on this little green part. It's kind of hard to see, but gotta pull carefully, especially this old stuff gets real brittle. So just gotta do this super carefully. There we go. Got that one. And then this one, need to make sure there's no wires that get caught in the teeth of my pliers here. And then we should be able to pull. Come on, there we go. Okay, so we need to clean this off, that's for sure. So that corrosion is just eating away the coating on here even. Looks like probably just paint maybe, but just a bunch of it. That's just crazy. that capacitor came off the board. Let's get a little closer on that. So there's the pins on the board and there's the capacitor, and it's just totally corroded away. It's a little crunchy in there, that's for sure. Okay, I think these pads are okay. What we'll have to do, once we get our hot iron in here, then we can really see if that's true or not. We're gonna have to really scrub on these pads to get all this corrosion off so we have something we can solder to, but we can worry about that later. Let's get this board out so we can have a better look at it. Okay, and with all the screws out, we can pull the board out. Definitely some corrosion in there. Not too bad though in there. Let's look at the other side. Okay, that's actually not too bad. There's a few spots of corrosion over here. The main thing we need to deal with is on the other side. Let's start with some isopropyl alcohol. Just give this board a good scrub down. Okay, and honestly, looking at it, it really doesn't look that bad other than these two points right here possibly. But I think what we need to do is just replace all these capacitors just like we did on the previous board. And I'm gonna do that part off camera. You guys have already seen that. But what I will do on camera is get these battery contacts replaced. We need to give this a good cleaning first, then we can do that. I think I will take out the power board so we can really get in and clean all of that corrosion out over there. Power board looks, as far as I can tell, undamaged. Even these contacts look good right here. So we may need to replace the capacitors on here as well, but as far as I can tell, everything looks mostly fine on this. We've got a little bit of corrosion on these and these. So let's just remove all of these and then we will fix them all up. So now I'm just gonna get a little bowl of vinegar. We'll see how these clean up. If they don't look too bad when we're done, then we'll just reinstall them. If not, we'll replace them. So I have all the capacitors on this board replaced, but before we get to the cleaning, I want to check this power board to make sure it's putting out the amount of power that it needs. The Retro 6 Wiki has a diagram that shows which pin should have how much voltage. So we're going to do those tests now and see if this power board is putting out those voltages. So plug it into power. We're going to check DC voltage. This is a ground pin. This should be 5 volts, and it's 0.5 volts. This should be 5 volts, and it is 0.5 volts. This should be 34 volts, and it's basically zero. Okay, let's flip this around. Make sure we have power coming in. So black probe on ground, red probe on positive 13.36. I believe that's how much voltage should be there. I believe this power switch is on, but let's move it over here just to make sure we're testing with the switch on. Let's make sure we don't get our correct voltages here. Yeah, we get nothing there now. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is replace these three capacitors on this power board, and then we'll retest and see if that gets it working. There are a number of ways that we could remove these capacitors. What I'm gonna try first is heating up each of these solder points, and I'll probably go back and forth a little bit and try to get them both liquid at the same time. I believe this is leaded solder, which means that the solder stays liquid a little bit longer than unleaded, so that might give me enough time to just pull the capacitor right out. And then after that, I will probably bring my solder sucker in or some solder wick and wick out the holes or suck out the solder from the holes. Then we'll put the new capacitors in and solder them to the board. But first, we've always got to start with a good amount of flux. Flux just helps the solder flow. I like to use a lot of it because that just makes everything easier. Okay, and here we go. These are big capacitors, so I'm going to be using my finger to pull down. And that is working. I'm just pulling on the side that is liquid, and that one just pulled right out. This one I can get my soldering iron right on both of them. Oh, that was easy. And same with this one. Come on. Almost. There we go. Let's bring some solder wick over here. See if we can clean these holes out. That one looks pretty good. Oh yeah, that looks great. So I'm just gonna come in and install the new capacitors. just like this. Oh, those holes didn't get all the way cleaned out, and neither did those ones. I thought they were. Okay, well, let's do that first then. Now I came in and put some more flux on there just to make sure that there's plenty of flux. And then I'm going to solder these legs back on. So I have the legs bent right now, and that's just to hold the capacitors in. I'm just gonna come in, solder them just like that. Now I'm just gonna come in with my flush cutters and cut each of these wires. These are more annoying. There we go. Just need to clean it off, but it's as easy as that. And now let's check the voltages on here. We've got 4.9, 5.3, should have a ground, and I think 3 grounds? 1, 2, 3, yep. And 1.2, which is what we should have. This should be battery voltage. 10.6. This should be 34 volts. We've got 10. No, this is battery voltage. I think we've got two pins of battery voltage, these two right here. Okay, and this should be the high voltage one, 44.8. Should be 34. I don't think it's a problem that it's higher, at least hopefully not. So that tells me that this power board is now working. And now that that's working, let's move on to getting the cleaning done. Now, before we get to the cleaning, let's just turn this on and make sure the thing even works. Oh, that didn't look good. Okay. Oh, we got lines on the screen and it comes on and turns right back off. Oh, there we go, we got it on. I mean, that's sort of good, I guess. Oh boy, I don't like having vertical lines on the screen like that. But also, there's a game in it, the game's not playing, so I feel like there's something going on here. Okay, there's no point in cleaning it when we have this other stuff going on, so let's see if we can figure out this screen issue, this display issue, and then we'll move on from there. We know the power board's good, so that shouldn't be the problem, so there must be something else going on this board right here. Let's first try some resistance testing to see if we have any shorts on the board, and then we'll move on from there. So when I come down here to these capacitors down here, this should be the positive side, and we get a beep saying that that is shorted to ground. Positive side of that one we get a beep. Let's try over here. No beep. No beep. No beep. Okay, so it seems like we've got an issue right down here. So one of the things that all of these are connected to, at least I think they're connected to, is this chip right here. I don't know if this chip is bad or not, but I'm gonna take it off and see if the short goes away. And after looking at the pads where the chip came off of, this chip is actually connected to the ground plane right here, and this capacitor and this capacitor are not connected to that ground plane on the plus side. It looks like they are, but they're actually not. So that chip has nothing to do with these capacitors. I'm not sure why these are showing up as shorted though. Unfortunately, there's no schematic on this VA4, at least that I can find online. So I'm gonna do a little bit more checking. I don't wanna call this one unfixable, but I'm just not sure if I'm gonna be able to fix this one, especially if I can't find any sort of schematic for it. And unfortunately, after checking this board out a little bit more, there's just no leads. I just have nowhere to go. There's just two shorted capacitors down here, and that's all I can find. I don't have another board unless this blue one is a similar board or the same board. I don't have another board to compare numbers. I don't see a schematic anywhere. So right now, we're gonna call this one maybe not fixable. Let's get this blue one opened up though and see if there's a board in that that is the same board, and then maybe we can compare numbers. Now this one is the one that I really care about here. Let's plug it in and see what happens when we try and play a game. Okay, let's start it up. Oh, we've got moving horizontal lines. I think that's good news. I think that usually means that it's the capacitors, which obviously would not surprise me at all. Let's get it opened up and check them out. And once again, we've got some pretty nasty corrosion over here and even some down here. But we'll worry about that later. Let's get the rest of this thing apart. See how the capacitors look on the inside. Okay. Oh, wow, look at this. Is that just glue? I think that's just adhesive. And we've got a VA1 board. Unfortunately, that means that we can't use this to test out that VA4 board, but we can replace all these capacitors. And maybe if we're lucky, that's all this one's gonna need. Famous last words, right? We got some corrosion over here. We can clean all that off pretty easily. So I'm gonna get all the capacitors on this replaced, all the capacitors on the audio board replaced, and then we'll put it back together and see if that's all it takes to fix this one. And now I have all of these capacitors replaced on this board, so this board is looking good. Let's get the battery contacts cleaned next. Oh, and here are all the capacitors we replaced out of these Sega Game Gears. I think it's safe to say capacitors are a major issue with Game Gears. So we just need to push down on this tab back here, and that will let it slide through. Same with this side. And all the rest of these that don't come out, we'll clean with it inside the Game Gear. Actually, that one's in pretty good condition. This one's not, and this one's not. So we'll clean those for sure while it's inside this thing. These three, though, we can clean in a little bowl of vinegar. And the good one, let's see what happens with this one. Oh yeah, look at that. That's bubbling very nicely. Getting all that battery acid removed from this. So I'll just let that do its thing for a little while, and then we will work on the battery contacts that are still in the Game Gear. I'm just gonna take a toothbrush with some white vinegar on it, drip it on there, and that will react with this battery acid and remove it. I'm gonna use my dental pick to scrape a little bit off as it's going here, just to speed up the process. Also wanna make sure it gets behind this one too. So we'll do that. Actually, that is looking pretty good. Unfortunately, the coating on this is not as good as it could be, but I think it's still gonna work fine. I'm gonna soak this up with a Q-tip. I don't think this will cause any long-term damage with the plastic, or short-term for that matter, but I just wanna make sure. That's also getting off some of the rust, so. Okay, that one's looking pretty good. Next, we need to do this one. Also, I'm just gonna drip it in over here as well, just to neutralize any of that battery acid. That just comes right off with the vinegar on it. Makes it super easy to clean these things. Now, some of you guys mentioned that I should do this with the Game Boys that I fixed a while back. I'll link that video here in a second too, so you can go watch that if you want to. And looking back on it, I probably should have done that. I think I used isopropyl alcohol. And I mean, clearly this vinegar is just working really nicely to get this off. So that will probably be my go-to for anything like this in the future, because it does just come right off. And now this battery contact, I mean, it looks basically brand new. And I will go ahead and soak this up with a Q-tip, and then we'll dry it out with some canned air and then air dry it for a bit just to make sure it's all nice and dry. Now let's go back to that bowl and see how those battery contacts are looking. So this one was the worst, and it actually looks really good. Front side and back side. I mean, as far as corrosion, you can see that some of the plating has been worn off. Some of the plating here has been worn off as well. But as far as the corrosion goes, that's just been totally cleaned off. I'm thinking I might want to go ahead and just replace this one since the coating is worn off of this part. But these two look pretty much brand new as well. So we're going to put our brand new battery contact in right here. There we go. Next, this one goes in just like this. Got to push it a little more down to get it to click. There we go, clicked in. And now same with this one. And there we go. And now we can get this fancy blue one all back together and see if all that work we did fixed it. So speaker, audio cable connection, power connection, then we can get the screws in and try it out. Put the other two batteries in. Battery covers. Be helpful if I put the right one in the right place. This is so nice looking. Game. Okay, we ready to test this? And here we go, let's test it and see if it's gonna turn on. Oh, look at that. It turns on, that's good news so far. Yeah, the speaker works, but does the game work? Sounds good so far. And the game does work. So I was able to fix two out of the three broken Sega Game Gears. I'm super excited about this blue one. We need to get this case a good cleaning, and then we've got a great Sega Game Gear branded case to go along with the console. If you like this type of video, you'll probably like the video where I bought six broken Nintendo Game Boys to see if I could fix those. I'll put a link for that video up on your screen now if you want to come check it out and see how many of those I could fix. Be sure to check out all our new merch over at TronicsFix.com. Thank you so much for watching today, and I hope you have a good one.